The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
Some of these other companies trying to say they're going to the transformation to AI, they have no idea how complicated it is. But we're doing it, and we've done it, and now we're going to scale AI.
Welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Frank Holmes. He's the executive chairman of Hive Digital Technologies. And Frank, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm outstanding in a bear market. That's great. You know, it's an incredible volatile time, and we continue to defy the odds. So it's great to be chatting with you.
Yeah, well, it shows in your quarterly numbers that you've just put out. Again, hitting record numbers, Frank. What jumps out to you right away?
Well, the revenue, if you take a look at Bitcoin, if you go today from a year ago, it's down slightly. But our revenue is up 285%. And quarter over quarter, our revenue is up 90%. And clearly, Bitcoin was not up any of those numbers. So we are capturing a bigger part of the global Bitcoin network. And we're getting that beautiful thing called economies of scale. And that's what's really key here.
Yeah, I noticed in some of the numbers I was reading, 86.2% quarter over quarter rise in average hash rate, a lift obviously in the Bitcoin pricing as well. So it seems that everything you're doing and the growth curve that you've been on continues to accelerate, Frank.
Yes, and we were pretty happy. You know, it's renewable energy. We're the only guys with that pure hydro focus, discipline, execution. Because I'm a big believer, execute or Mr. Market will execute you. So we've been doing a great job. That's an old Warren Buffett line, Steve. Mm-hmm. And we have diversified revenue. We have AI growth in addition to the incredible growth this year of Bitcoin to 25 exahash. And we have planned now another 100 megawatts and going up to 35 exahash next year. And then when you look at our HPC and that growth with Dell, with Bell, you want to yell. I got them all the rhymes going. I sound like a rapper now, but I'm teasing. Is that we are really in a position to show that we can execute, and we will do that on the AI. And I'm a little frustrated seeing some of these other companies trying to say they're going to the transformation to AI. They have no idea how complicated it is. But we're doing it, and we've done it, and now we're going to scale AI.
Frank, is a part of this the ability that you have with in-country to be able to put these infrastructure, like in Paraguay, up so quickly? I mean, it went from not much to completed and running in a short amount of time. I guess that's another reason why the success is there.
Yes, and the opportunity came when we started building our own 100 exahash, and Bitfarms wanted to get out of the country. And so we said no, and they were halfway through their construction, and we took it over. And then we fast-tracked it. They themselves said it went down. They were surprised how well we've executed. But the team down there every day would huddle twice a day with our team in Montreal and in Vancouver to make sure it's all hands on deck. And anything that came up was a gap to zap. We were going to zap it within 24 hours. So I think it was a phenomenal execution of teamwork in different languages, different time zones. We still show up as being the most efficient Bitcoin miner on the globe.
And Frank, lastly, I just want to take you back to your rap days, because you did mention Dell and you mentioned Bell. And I think it's important to bring those back in the conversation. Two very well-known, two established names now working with your BUZZ High Performance Computing division. That shows legitimacy right off the bat, but it also shows the need for this high computing within Canada and North America.
Steve, yeah, it's a great point, because a lot of people are not really cognizant that it's an arms race. And it's an arms race against China. And China has expanded their footprint substantially in electricity and also data centers and AI and robotics. So now we have to get caught up in the U.S. And the U.S. is much further ahead than Europe. If you look at the percentage of NVIDIA chips as a percentage of the population or GDP per capita type equation, you can see the U.S. is much further ahead than Europe or Canada. So Canada really has to get caught up to the U.S. In this sort of arms race to get data centers built and outfit it with the best GPU chips. And I think we're Canada's really focused on that, and our relationships with Bell and with Dell just validate the growth opportunities in Canada. We do have some of the best universities, Nobel Prize winner out of University of Toronto for the contribution to AI. So we think the all the scientists are there. So let's build the data center so they can really operate in Canada.
Frank, exciting times continuing to happen, and looks like it's going to happen for many months and years to come. So great to see you again. Thanks very much for the update.
Thank you.
All right, Frank Holmes, he's the Executive Chairman of Hive Digital Technologies.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.